Hello dear students, today we are going to start second part of the chapter sound. In our previous part, we discussed about what is sound, how it propagate and how the human produce sound. We also discussed that there are different mediums for the propagation of sound and what is the difference of speed in different medium of propagation. Also, we discussed about the voice box in human in detail. Today we are starting our session with few more topics. So let us start the second part of the chapter sound. Dear students, you must have noticed that we identify the sound without looking towards the object that produce sound. How it's possible? Why the quality of sound? What makes the quality of sound? What makes them different? All the sound differ from each other. What makes them different? Let us discuss the characteristics
of sound. Sound may be described by three characteristics: pitch, quality and loudness. And in turn, these three things are depend on frequency, amplitude and time period and waveform. Before discussing about each term, let us know what is vibration. Vibration is also known as oscillation. Oscillation means the movement of an object between one position and another, also called to and fro motion. The characteristic of oscillations can be seen with the help of frequency, amplitude and time period. What is frequency? The number of oscillation or vibration made by a vibrating body in 1 second is known as frequency. It also measures the pitch of the sound. And the SI unit of frequency is hertz, which is represented as capital H and small z. If a body makes 100 oscillation in 1 second, it means its frequency is 100 hertz. The next term that is very important, on which the loudness of sound depends, is amplitude. The maximum displacement of a vibrating object from its mean position is known as its amplitude. Amplitude helps to determine loudness or the volume of a sound. Larger the amplitude means the louder the sound, and the smaller the amplitude means softer is the sound. Third and the very important characteristic of sound is timbre, which is also known as quality of musical sound, which is used for differentiating two sounds when they are in the same frequency. Every sound that we hear is dependent on its source. Sound timbre is defined by the characteristic sound waveform, which is dependent on the material through which it is produced. Few more terms related to the vibration of sound. Here you can see that the amplitude means the displacement from the mean position. Also, you can see it covers equal distance on both sides. And when it completes equal distance on both sides and comes to the mean position, there it completes one complete wave or oscillation. It completes one oscillation or vibration. The distance between two adjacent compression is known as wavelength, and the time taken for completion of one wave or oscillation is called time period. It is measured in seconds. Here we have completed the characteristic of sound waves.
Dear students, let us discuss how we hear. We know that sound are produced as wave in the air or any other medium. As these sound travels to our ears, they convert them into electric signal or message that our brain can understand. Our ears have special structure that allows these function. There are three major parts of human ear that are inner, outer and middle ear. The outer part of ear is called pinna. Pinna collects the sound from the surrounding and then it reaches the eardrum. Eardrum is thin rubber like sheet, as you can see. As the sound waves reaches the eardrum waves and forward them to the next part of ear, that is the middle ear. The middle ear, it converts the sound wave into the vibration that then travel to the inner ear. It moves inward and outward to create vibrations. These vibrations are then picked up by the several types of cell in the inner ear. From the inner ear, the vibrations are sent to the brain in the form of signals. The brain perceives these oscillations or signals as a sound. Inner ear is called cochlea. It receives the vibrations sent by the eardrum. Here you can see the different parts of human ear. The outer ear, it is called pinna, that receives sound waves and forward them to the next part, which is called middle ear. In middle ear, you can see the vibrations are transferred from eardrum and they are passed through three bones present in middle ear to inner ear. The inner ear main is cochlea. It receives the vibration by eardrum through middle ear. It contains a liquid substance and the vibration that enters the inner ear moves through this liquid. There are tiny hairs present inside the inner ear that turns the vibration into signals for the brain. In this way, the brain receives the signal, auditory signal. Here we are going to end today's session. In our next session, we will discuss the remaining part of the chapter. Till then, take care and have a nice day ahead.